I'm Jan Harris, the director of the Career Services Center at Community College of Philadelphia. The Career Services Center is your link to figuring out what you're going to do when you graduate from the college. We can assist you with resumes, cover letters, as well as planning a job search strategy and figuring out how to apply for jobs online. Today, you're going to participate in our mock interview program. Tracey Hanton, coordinator of career planning, and Marvin Marcellus, a student at the college majoring in architecture, are going to participate in a mock interview. A mock interview is a really great way for you to practice your interviewing skills in a safe environment. So there's no job on the line, you answer the questions, you can fumble, you can lose your train of thought, and there is no job slipping through your fingers. You get asked lots of questions so that you can figure out what you might be asked during a regular interview. So Tracey Hanton is going to interview Marvin Marcellus, and we're going to see that interview. When she's done with Marvin, she's going to give him a positive critique of his performance, telling him what he's done really well, showing him where he has not done as well, and then offering suggestions for how he can correct that behavior and do better in another interview. And then she's going to invite him to do it again. Practice makes perfect. So if you don't do well in the interview process the first time, do it again, so that you get better and you can sell yourself to the employer. In this tough economic time, the person who can do the best job of explaining to the interviewer why they're a good match is going to be the better candidate for the position.
Hi, Marvin, how are you? Tracey Hanton.
Hey, how are you?
Okay, why don't you have a seat?
Thanks.
Before we get started, do you have a resume?
No, not really.
Okay.
I keep the information up here.
Okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I just have a few questions to ask you in regards to our summer internship program.
Mm-hmm.
And once I finish asking these questions, it'll kind of give me a good idea about the type of worker you might be for our firm.
Okay? All right.
So the first question is, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm 22. I like to ride my bike. I like hanging out with my friends, and I like architecture. Yeah.
Okay, well, that's a good thing. Can you describe a time when you had to demonstrate leadership qualities?
Oh, so this one time, me and my friends, we were out playing paintball, and I was like the group leader, and so I went out, you know, front and like, you know, did the whole crossfire thing. It was real cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. If I contacted your former coworkers or your current coworkers, what do you think they'd say about you?
I don't know. I don't really like them like that. They might not say good things about me. Maybe you shouldn't do that.
Okay. Okay. Can you name three strengths and two weaknesses? And with the weaknesses, can you tell me what you're doing to make some improvements with those?
I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
Name three strengths. What are three of your strong points?
Okay.
And two things that are not so strong about you that you know you need to be working on, and what you're doing to work on those.
Okay. A strength, I'm like determined.
Okay, determined.
Very yeah. Strength. I'm not really sure. Like, this doesn't have to do anything to do with weights, does it?
No.
Oh. I don't really know.
Okay. What about two weaknesses?
What
are two areas that you need some improvement on?
I think, like, I'm shy. And, like, I want to write better.
Okay. And what are you doing to work on those two things?
Homework.
Okay. Can you give me an example of a time when you had to work in a team setting? What problems arose? What was the outcome?
Okay. Let me see, team setting. Okay, like about two summers back, I was building a bike for my little brother, right? And it was me and my buddy. So we just, you know, started trying to build it from scratch and stuff like that. we ended up throwing out the directions because who needs those, right? And so he started one on the other bike, and I started on the other end, and then the bike really never got finished, but we tried.
Okay.
Yeah.
So from that, mm-hmm. what did you learn?
Maybe we should have kept the directions. Maybe.
Okay. How do you motivate others or yourself? What things do you do to gain motivation?
I watch music videos. And the HGTV, like, you know, the home and garden stuff. It's real cool. You know, because architecture now.
Okay. What are your salary requirements?
I'm trying to make money as much as possible.
Okay. What do you hope to get out of this particular internship?
Just more experience, you know, because I've been going to school for it, so now I want to actually, you know, get some hands-on experience.
Okay. What made you actually kind of get into this particular field?
I think it was just driving around and seeing, like, construction work going on, and I thought it looked really cool, like, what they were doing. And I found out that there are people called architects that actually design these buildings, so, you know, I figured, hey, I could be one of them, right?
Okay. What are your, what classes in the architecture program have you excelled at the most?
I really like the design courses in the studio because, you know, I can be creative and draw.
Okay. Is there anything else that you would like to let me know about you so I can make a good decision as to whether or not to bring you into the firm for the summer?
Well, I mean, I'm a real cool guy, you know, like to chill out, and so I think I'd be a good fit.
Okay. Well, we're going to be making a decision in about 2-3 weeks. And you should be hearing something from us either way, okay?
Sweet.
Thank you for coming in.
Thanks.
All righty. Okay, Marvin. What we're going to do now is we're just going to watch the video of the mock interview, and then I'm just going to give you some pointers. But first, I'd like to know, how did you feel about the interview?
I think it went good.
Okay, were you nervous or anything?
A little, yeah, a little.
Okay. Well, we're just going to watch the video and talk about some things, you know, where you can maybe improve at, okay?
Okay.
All right. Hi, Marvin. How are you? Tracey Hanton.
Hey, how are you?
Okay. Why don't you have a seat?
Thanks.
Before we get started, do you have a resume?
No, not really.
Okay.
I keep the information up here.
Okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I just have a few questions to ask you in regards to our summer internship program.
Mm-hmm.
And once I finish asking these questions, it'll kind of give me a good idea about the type of worker you might be for our firm.
All right.
Okay?
All right.
So the first question is, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm 22. I like to ride my bike. I like hanging out with my friends. And I like architecture.
I'm going to pause it right here. Couple things that I noticed. You didn't come in with a resume. You want to always make sure that you have a resume. Okay, even though it was just a practice interview, mm-hmm. it's to get you together for the real interview. So you want to come in with that. Also, when you're meeting with an employer, if the position requires that you might need a portfolio, you want to make sure that you bring your portfolio so that the employer can actually see your design work and that sort of thing. Okay. Another area that was a little problematic was your dress, okay, and the clothes that you wore.
My dress?
Mm-hmm. First thing, you should always remove your hat when you come into the building. So you should never have a hat during an interview.
Sorry.
Okay? No problem. Also, you want to make sure that you wear the right style of clothing for the right type of firm that you're going to. You're going to an architecture firm. So one of the things that you should have is you should have a nice pressed suit, pressed shirt, tie,
and just a crisp kind of look, okay, and very professional. Okay, so remember that you're not going to be coming in khaki pants and things of that nature. All right?
Okay.
With the first question that I asked, that was a tell me about yourself. And the type of answer that you gave was a more personal answer. The employer is not looking for information regarding your age, how you like to spend your free time or anything like that. The employer is looking for information about your major, the type of classes that you've taken, a little bit about your skills and abilities. So that's where you want to try the focus at. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Now we're just going to take a look at some more things, okay?
All right.
Can you describe a time when you had to demonstrate leadership qualities?
Oh, so this was one time me and my friends, we were out playing paintball, and I was like the group leader. And so I went out, you know, front and like, you know, did the whole crossfire thing. It was real cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. If I contacted your former coworkers or your current coworkers, what do you think they'd say about you?
I don't know. I don't really like them like that. They might not say good things about me. Maybe you shouldn't do that.
Okay. Okay. Can you name three strengths and two weaknesses? And with the weaknesses, can you tell me what you're doing to make some improvements with those?
I'm sorry. Can you repeat that?
Name three strengths. What are three of your strong points?
Okay.
And two things that are not so strong about you that you know you need to be working on, and what you're doing to work on those.
Okay. Strength, I'm like determined.
Okay, determined.
Very yeah. Strength. I'm not really sure. Like, this doesn't have to do anything to do with weights, does it?
I'm going to pause it right here.
Yeah, it was kind of tough.
Okay. First thing, I asked you to describe a time about your leadership abilities. One of the things you want to make sure when you get ready to go into an interview, you want to make sure that you've identified areas where you've excelled at. If you're part of different organizations where you have to demonstrate leadership abilities, this is a good time to bring that information out. Okay?
Okay.
Also, when I asked you about your former coworkers, you kind of put a very negative spin on it about whether or not you like your coworkers and whether or not they like you. That's not where you want to be at. You want to talk about what you think they would say in terms of how you work at the job. So if they were going to say, if you are always on time, that would be one of the things that you would think that they might say, is that Marvin always comes to work on time. When we need Marvin to do a task, Marvin does the task. So those are the types of things that you want to be thinking about.
Well, that's actually why they don't like me. They think I'm brown-nosing.
Okay, but whether or not they like you or not isn't the point.
Okay.
Is what would they say in terms of your work abilities and your work ethic?
Okay.
Okay, so that's kind of like where you want to really, really steer at.
Okay.
Okay, and remove it from whether or not you like them, they like you. And it would go the same way if I had asked you, what would your boss say about you? You wouldn't want to give me any negative feedback about your boss. You would always want to try to make sure that you could put a positive spin on it.
Okay.
Okay, so what you did is you just left out some really good information that the employer would have needed to know, that you come to work on time and that you do the job that you're asked to do and those sorts of things. So you want to make sure that you don't miss those key pieces.
Okay.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're just going to take a look some more at the video, okay?
All right.
I don't really
okay.
know.
What about two weaknesses? What are two areas that you need some improvement on?
I think, like, I'm shy. And, like, I want to write better.
Okay. And what are you doing to work on those two things?
Um, homework.
Okay. Can you give me an example of a time when you had to work in a team setting? What problems arose? What was the outcome?
Okay. Let me see, team setting. Okay, like about 2 summers back, I was building a bike for my little brother, right? And it was me and my buddy. So we just, you know, started trying to build it from scratch and stuff like that. We ended up throwing out the directions because who needs those, right? And so he started one on the other bike and I started on the other end. And then the bike really never got finished, but we tried.
Couple things with that one. I asked you about a time when you had to work in a team setting. And actually, the example that you gave wasn't really a bad example, but you just didn't really pull out all the teamwork pieces that you needed to. I also asked what problems arose. Mm-hmm. And that was a prime time to say, well, you know, we found that it was very difficult once we had thrown out the instructions to really know which pieces came together, you know, when we were bringing the bike together from one end to the other. Mm. You also, when you talked about the outcome of the project, you know, just some key things that you want to be thinking about.
Okay.
When you think of working in a team setting, you also, instead of using something as personal, you again could have looked into some activities and things that you've done on campus, okay? And you could have utilized those. I'm sure there have been probably many opportunities where you've actually worked in a team setting, even if it was just to complete an in-class project,
You're right.
So again, what you want to do is you don't want to lose any opportunity to allow your qualities to shine forth, all right? And again, with the strengths and weaknesses, you need to know what they are. Now, you used the term, you were shy, and that can be considered a weakness, but again, you should have put a very positive spin on that, okay? And so you need to think of what makes being shy a weakness, how has it hindered me, mm-hmm. and what am I doing to overcome it? It may be just as simple as walking up and just introducing yourself. So you need to think of what are some things that I can do to actually overcome that. Okay, is all of this, is it making sense? Does it sound like some things that you could actually do to get some improvement? Because again, like you said, you really want to get that experience in architecture.
I do.
So you're gonna have to do that. So we're just gonna look at the last couple questions, all right? And then we'll wrap it up.
All right.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So from that, mm-hmm. what did you learn?
Maybe we should have kept the directions. Maybe.
Okay. How do you motivate others or yourself? What things do you do to gain motivation?
I watch music videos. And the HGTV, like, you know, the home and garden stuff. It's real cool. You know, because architecture.
Okay. What are your salary requirements?
I'm trying to make money as much as possible.
Okay. What do you hope to get out of this particular internship?
Just more experience, you know, because I've been going to school for it, so now I want to actually, you know, get some hands-on experience.
Okay. What made you actually kind of get into this particular field?
I think it was just driving around and seeing like construction work going on, and I thought it looked really cool, like what they were doing. And I found out that there are people called architects that actually design these buildings. So, you know, I figured, hey, I could be one of them, right?
Okay. What are your what classes in the architecture program have you excelled at the most?
I really like the design courses in the studio because, you know, I can be creative and draw.
Okay. Is there anything else that you would like to let me know about you
so I can make a good decision as to whether or not to bring you into the firm for the summer.
Well, I mean, I'm a real cool guy, you know, I like to chill out, and so I think I'd be a good fit.
Okay. Now, based off of some of the things that I've already said, can you kind of see where you, again, left out some key areas?
Yeah.
Okay. I asked you to give me more information to help me make a decision. This would have also been a good time to come in and, again, pull from some other experiences that you had, some leadership skills that you had, even some things at your current job that you're doing, that where you could have said, I'm a conscientious worker. And then toward the end, when I asked, how did you get involved in this particular field? You talked about construction. You talked about thinking, hey, this might be something that I can do. You talked about how you're creative. Those are all the things that you want to kind of bring more to the forefront, okay? Yeah. A couple things just in terms of appearance that you want to watch out for. Mm-hmm. You want to watch out for your eye motions, mm-hmm. okay? Eye contact is very important.
Okay.
But you also want to make sure that you're not rolling your eyes and things of that nature. And I'm sure you noticed on the video that there were a couple times where your eyes kind of went up in your head and things.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's just something that you have to work on. The best way to do that, get in front of a mirror, talk in front of the mirror, take these questions, study the questions, answer the questions in front of the mirror. That way you can actually see what's happening. Another thing, your hand motions. Okay, mm-hmm. You want to make sure that they don't go all over the place. A couple of times your hands kind of went up a lot. You want to make sure that you maintain a very professional outlook about yourself. Mm-hmm. So some of your street motions, you want to put them really to the back burner. Okay. You want to make sure you have good posture, sitting up straight, leaning forward to show that you're interested in what the employer's saying. You don't want to slouch down in a chair like you did a lot, you know, like you were hanging out. Okay, so you want to make sure. And you want to make sure that when you're giving descriptions, that they really do relate to the job. The one thing an architecture firm might not want is a person who's so laid back to the point that they can't make the deadlines because they're just hanging out with everyone, okay? So you want to make sure that you don't give information that kind of, you know, blows your opportunity, basically, all right? So hopefully you'll take that information that I've given you, you'll go and you'll practice it, and you can schedule another mock interview. And come back in, and we'll see how you do then.
All right, thank you very much.
Oh, you're quite welcome. It was a pleasure.
Pleasure.
All right.
Hi, Marvin. How are you?
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
Good. Nice to meet
you. Have a seat.
Thank you.
Oh, thanks for coming in.
Well, thanks for having me.
Okay. Do you have a resume?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
How's your day today?
Oh, it's going fine. It's going fine.
All right.
Thanks for asking. Okay. All righty. Well, what I'm going to be doing is just trying to get a feel for the type of worker you might be and see if you really fit with our architect firm.
Very well.
Okay. So I'm just going to ask a few questions. The first question I want to know is, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm an architecture student. I'm working on, brandishing my skills and getting some hands-on experience. I really enjoy the courses that I've taken so far, and I really want to dive into the field.
Okay.
If you're interested in seeking out more information about the Career Services Center, please contact us at Community College of Philadelphia.